Hello chess friends, this is Sir Glenn and I'm back again para sa isa na namang lesson sa chess. So this time I just want to teach you about a certain variation in Sicilian, often called Sicilian Kalashnikov, but there's some confusion in there because the real name of this variation is Sicilian Lowenthal variation. Usually originated with the game between Labor de Nice and Lowenthal, or I'm sorry, MacDonellian in 1834, and it was popular. Sikat ito nung bandang 1940s, even up to the 60s. Only in 1980s did see that after knight b5, it is also possible to play d6 instead of. Okay, so here's the initial variation. So the Lowenthal variation starts with a6, allowing a knight check here, no? Inaallow yung check dito ng white, and then kakainin siya ng bishop, i-give up ng black yung bishop pair kapalit ng lead in development, because after queen takes f6, knight takes f6, kung mapapansin nyo, white has the two bishops pero yung dalawang knights ng black nakalabas na. So this is the immediate idea of this variation. So let's try to go back a little bit. Katulad nga sinasabi ko kanina, instead of a6, there was a time in 1980s where d6 was played with the idea of a6 pushing the knight back here. So like, for example, white plays knight 1 to c3, black plays a6, and white has nothing better but to play knight a3. So makikita natin na kapalit ng backward pawn ng black, nasabi natin backward pawn ang isang pawn kapag wala na siyang pawn support sa adjacent files o sa mga katabing files niya, and then hindi siya rin siya makapush dahil kontrolado yung square in front of him. So that's the Kalashnikov variation. So we don't have that because we are to discuss the a6 variation. So after knight d6, bishop takes d6, queen takes d6, and queen f6. This variation, the Sicilian, is quite actually popular sa tournament level. I met this opening several times sa mga non-master tournaments. I had 2 wins and 1 draw with it. Actually, I nearly lost one of the drawn game I have. And this contains some venom, especially kung first time lang to ma-meet ng white, no? Okay, so what are the main plans and ideas of both sides or both colors from this line? Let's try to look and see. First is white tries to adopt a solid Yugoslav formation. So ito yung actually from this position, white has 3 main tries, no? The main line, which starts from the queen retreat, no, declining the exchange, is either to play queen d2, queen d3, or queen d1, which theory would consider queen d1 as the best move. And other is to try to complicate matters by playing queen c7, which I consider a very suspect for white, since black will be expecting this queen c7 move. And in some lines, the queen might either be trapped or cannot help from black's onslaught. No, hindi siya makakatulong sa atake ng black dahil siniksik niya yung sarili niya dyan, no? And I don't really think it's a good line. And queen takes f6, which goes to the main idea of black, trying to hold back black's attack, saying, okay, wala namang queen, eh, matatakos sa atake. And if it reached the end game, then 2 bishops ako. So yun yung pinaka main idea ng white. So let's try to look at the main line, which starts from queen d1. Okay? Well, queen d1, the next black's move is to attack white's weaknesses, which is the e4 pawn, the g2 pawn, and use his lead in development to open up the position and makes at gumawa ng threat sa position ng white, no? So after queen e4, now if white plays bishop d3, the g2 pawn will hang. Makakain yung pawn dito pag gumalaw tong bishop na to. So White has to play knight c3 instead. Okay. And then black plays knight ge7. After knight ge7, katulad nga sinabi ko, yung first plan, white adopts a Yugoslav formation which composed of f3, bishop e3, queen d2, and castle queenside. Let's see the perfect example or user, grandmaster, na gumagamit ng plano na to. According to my research, was Sevestar Gligoric. Okay? Let me just show you some of his games. Starting from this position, he plays bishop e3. Okay, so bishop e3, castle. And after castle, queen d2. And strangely enough, black plays d6. Although, eventually it will be played. Kaya lang pag dinilay pa ng black ng isang move after castle queenside, medyo hindi niya, lalo siyang magiging backward, hindi niya na maipupush to at mahihirapan siyang ilabas tong light square bishop niya. So, it has to be played now. And after d6, queen d2, b5 was played. No, it's white's turn, so I'm sorry. Castle queenside was played. Rook d8, f3, b5, and king b1. Tama ba ako? Yes. And after king b1, bishop e6, knight d5, rook ac8, and then white plays the solid bishop d3, no? Kung mapapansin natin, pag hindi pwedeng kumain ng parang hanging po ng white, no? Kasi black can capture twice on the d5 square. Pero hindi niya magagawa yun kasi after pawn takes whatever piece na kakain sa d5, this diagonal against black's queen on g6 will be open. So, hindi pwedeng gawin yon. So, after rook a8, bishop d3, black plays f6. Okay. Usually, it's a rule na kung saan yung active bishop mo, kung halimbawa white yung active bishop mo, sa green mo ilalagay yung mga pawns mo. Pag ang active bishop mo naman ay dark squared bishop o yung green na bishop, ilalagay mo naman sa puti yung mga pawn mo. That's usually a general rule sa middle game. So, after f6, white tries to defend the c-pawn, rook c1. And then, black plays queen f7. And then, the freeing move, c4. After c4, I think Gligoric's position here is very good. No? Dahil yung backward d-pawn, medyo na-fix niya sa d6. And then, possible if there are complications, nagkaroon ng simplification sa position ng exchanges, this queenside majority versus 2 versus 1 majority will prove very useful to him sa endgame, no? Kapag nag-try na siyang gumawa ng fast pawn. So, let's try to look at the rest of the game, rest of the moves, and let's see how Gligoric executes his plan. So, the next move doesn't need any remaining comment kasi it can be easily understood. So, makikita natin nag-sacrifice ng pawn yung black. I don't really know what for. Kasi kung basta lang nag-amatras kung saan yung knight, Gligoric will play bishop takes pawn, and he has already a very large advantage kasi may dalawang connected pass pawn na siya sa queen side. So, sinubukang guluhin ni Rosetto, kalaban ni Gligoric. Nangyari ito sa Santa Fe Tournament 1960. So, after knight d4, takes, and then bishop takes pawn. It's very clear na black just tries to barely hold on, and it's really winning for Gligoric. So, karoon siya ng konting play. Still, it's insufficient para masabing justified yung kanyang sacrifice. So here, even Gligoric tries to give the f3 pawn, but if that happens, rook e1 or maybe, yeah, I think rook e1 is also possible, or rook takes d6 would be too obvious for him. With c3, b8, takes. Takes. Ayan. And after bishop takes g6, this loses the rook or will be up a rook. Strong for white. Okay, so let's look at the second game. Gligoric's opponent is Benko. And this happens in Dublin, 1957. They went for the same opening, of course, which is the topic of our discussion. And after the following opening moves, okay, siya nga pala, after knight f6, we just transpose, knight ge7, queen g6 are very transpositional moves, so it doesn't matter what move goes first. After queen g6, it's e3, white plays bishop e3, castle, queen d2, d6. And then after castle queenside, black goes again for rook b8, king b1, b5. And here, white plays f3, bishop e6. D5 goes for the same line again. I think na doble ko lang, pero this is a very good position for white. It goes, it's practically the same moves. I have the same moves. Siguro ano lang to, duplicate. Kasi this source I got this from chessgames.com. Sometimes they have duplicates, so I think this is one of those cases. Okay, let's try to discuss another line. Okay, so from this position, instead of playing queen d1, meron din option ng white to play queen d2. The idea is the possibility to play queen g5 at saka ipwesto tong bishop sa b2, no? Which happens in this game between Lecco and Vallejo Pons. This is just recent. It happens in Linares 2005. And after queen d2, game develops like this. Knight d5, queen h4, and after takes takes, black plays d5, and here, surprisingly, white did not play bishop takes e5, kasi nga may kain sa e4. And also, Lecco didn't play pawn takes pawn kasi nga may push sa e4 ulit. Or possible that after bishop takes g2, magkakaroon ng pressure sa kingside. And okay, possible kingside attack for black. No, I don't really know what happens after pawn takes d5. But I trust their judgment kasi pares lang GM. So, what Lecco did was to play queen e3. Which is also reasonable move. And after d4, queen g3. And then they decided to swap the queens. And after h63 knight c6, and then he decides to break the pawn chain. Ayan, c takes d4 knight takes d4 king e3, and then king takes d3 a4 f4 and f6. So actually this is a very long game, and it ended in a draw after 67 moves. But let's try to assess the position after the opening. As you can see, black has some pressure, white has the two bishops, and anything can happen. Let's try to get past or lagpasan yung position na medyo wala na masyadong tension, no? So after, actually after what do you call this, f6 he relieves the pressure by taking on a4, and after rook takes e4, rook hc1, rook hc1, and then after exchange on a2, and exchange on e5, white plays rook c5. Ayan, no? So nagkaroon ng pressure sa e5, and after knight c6, takes king f8. Okay, let's look at the position. It's probably equal, kaya nga siguro nagdraw. But pawns tries to push the game since meron siyang isolated outside pass pawn dito sa queen side. But still, it was drawn after 67 moves. So from this position, which is the 29th move after king f8, they proceed to continue to play until it was drawn. Okay? Okay, I'll show you the next plan on my next video, which shows what happens if white plays queen takes f6. Thank you for listening, guys, and hope to catch you again. Bye.